Hey guys, it's Priyanka. In the last tutorial, we completed the get current location part. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to search for a particular place. So first, we are going to make some changes in the layout file. So open the RES folder. You will find a layout folder inside that and click on the activitymaps.xml file and click on the text tab, so you will be able to see the code. So as you can see, there is only one element here, that is the fragment. So we are going to add a relative layout here. So write relative layout, and this fragment will be inside the relative layout. So just open it here and close it after the fragment. And it is giving an error because we need to add the two default attributes that must be added. Those attributes are layout height and layout width. So write Android colon layout underscore height and Android colon layout underscore width. And for both the values, I'm going to write match parent. Match parent means it will take the maximum value, and it is still giving an error, so click alt enter, so this line will get added here. As you can see, the layout height and width attributes of the fragment are also equal to match parent. So I'm going to change the value of height. So I'm going to experiment, so I'll write 400. It is too small, so maybe, okay, I think 470 works. So write 470 dp and then click on the design tab. Now click on text and drag this plain text here, and these are all the properties of this text field. So I'm going to change the ID, so write tf location, because the user will enter the location here. And I'm going to remove this, so this will be blank. And I'm going to change the width, so maybe 200 is too small, so yeah, 300 dp. And I'm going to add a button, so click all and drag the button here. And for the button also, I'm going to change the ID. So write B search. And for the text, I'm going to write search. And there is one more property that I'm going to change. So search for on click. And here I'm going to write on click. Or you can write anything here. We just need to make sure that whatever you write here, we are going to make a method in the Java file with that same name. So I just wrote on click here. So we are done with this layout file. So we are going to work on the maps activity.java file now. So we'll create that method now. So write public void on click, and here it will take view, and it is giving an error, so click alt enter, so this class will get imported. Then we need to check if the user clicked on the search button or not. So write if v.getId is equal to r.id.bSearch. Then once the user clicked on the search button, we are going to take whatever the user entered in the text field, and then we'll search for that place. So first we need to get whatever the user entered in the text field. So for that, write edit text tf location equals edit text find view by id r.id.bSearch TF location, that is the ID of the text field. And here click Alt Enter and click on import class. So this class will get imported here. Then we need to convert it to string. So write string location equals TF location dot get text dot to string. Now we need to check if the user actually entered something or not. So for that, write location dot equals, and I'm going to add a not here. That means if this is not an empty string, then we can move forward. So I'm going to use Geocoder class here. So as you can see that the Geocoder class has these four methods, and I'm going to use the get from location name method, which takes two attributes, location name and max results, and it returns a list of addresses. You can find all of this information on developer.android.com. So I'm going to create an object of Geocoder class. So write geocoder equals new geocoder, and I'm going to pass this here for the context. Then I'm going to create a list, but I'm going to declare it outside the if block. So write list of address list, and I'm going to use it here. Address list equals geocoder dot get from location name, and it will take two attributes, string location name and max results. So for the location name, I'm going to write location, and for the max results, you can write anything. I'm going to write 5, and it is giving an error because we need to insert this in a try catch block. So you can just write Alt Enter and click on surround with try catch. So that error is gone now. Now what I'm going to do is, if you search for a particular location, this can return a list of maybe 2 or 3 addresses. Then I'm going to put a marker on all of those 3 addresses. So for that, I'm going to use a for loop. So write for int I equals 0, I less than. So now we need to check what is the size of that address list. So for that, write address list dot size i++. It is giving an error because we need to initialize this variable. So you can just initialize it to null. Now inside the for loop, I'm going to write address, my address equals address list dot get, and here I'm going to pass I. And then for each address, I'm going to create a lat-lang object. And I'm going to pass 2 values. And those 2 values are latitude and longitude. So write my address dot get latitude, my address dot get longitude. Now we need to create marker options. We can create marker option outside the if block. So write marker options mo equals new marker options, and we can set the position inside the for loop. So write mo dot position, pass latlang here. I'm not going to add a title, but you can add it like this, mo dot title, and then write anything you want. You can write your search result maybe, and then you can also set an icon, but I'm just going to leave it as it is because it will just set it to the default icon. Then I'm going to add this marker to the map. So write mmap dot add marker, and here we need to pass the marker options, so pass mo. And then we can either animate the camera to that location, but it can give you multiple results. So when you do this, the camera will focus on the last result given. So you can do it or you can just leave it as it is, but I'll do it. So you'll be able to see what I'm seeing. So at mmap.animateCamera and pass camera update factory dot new latlang and pass latlang here. So now we can run it and test it. So connect your phone to the laptop and make sure that you have enabled USB debugging. If you don't know how to do that, I will put a link in the description box below and you can check it out. So after that, click on the run button and select your device and click OK. So first it will show you your current location. And then you can enter any place. I'll write Paris and click search. So as you can see, it added two markers and it switched the view to this location because the last result was this location. I didn't know there was a place called Paris here. Okay, so this is how you do it. So that's it for today. If you have any questions, then you can email me or leave a comment. I'll try to answer all of your questions. So thank you for watching this video. Make sure to subscribe to my channel. And if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. Thank you.